Now I feel pain-free.
That's fantastic. And is that because you train less, or?
I run less, but I train more.
So I'm Jonas from Memover, and today I have Brian with me. Can you tell me who you are?
Yeah, I'm Brian. I'm a family dad. Have a full-time job, and besides that, I'm a ultrarunner on the national team level.
And what is an ultrarunner?
Ultrarunner is anything more than marathon, but for me it's a 6-hour run and 100Ks.
6 hours and 100Ks?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you do a lot of training?
Yeah.
So in start November you bought a Memover. Yeah. Tell me, what's the point of that? What were you thinking?
Yeah, as an ultrarunner you have to train a lot. You have to run a lot, and there is always a risk of some injuries. So yeah. The plan was to have some alternative training, to cut the top of the running, but still train a little bit more. And that's why I bought the Memover this winter.
And also to get some core stability?
Exactly, because I have had some troubles in the past with some small injuries in the spring. When the season was about to start, yeah. I always had 2 months where I couldn't run because of pain in the back and pain in the thighs. Yeah. That's now. Now I feel pain-free.
That's fantastic. And is that because you train less, or?
I run less, but I train more.
So you train more in total?
Yeah.
And how do you fit that into your life?
Yeah, basically it's because I take the Memover when I go to work.
Okay. So the time you take out of family life is less now, even though you train more?
It's a little bit less. The Memover is same pace as my bicycle.
And then comes to a $100 million question. So how does this affect your performance after 4 months?
The main part, I'm not injured.
Yeah.
But I have some test run. I have a marathon in 2:40, and that's good for January from my point of view. I just ran a 100K in 7 hours and 21 minutes. That's pretty good for this time of the season. World lead at this time.
Yeah. But it's number one in the world in 100 kilometer race right now.
Season is still young, but but nonetheless.
Yeah.
So it's pretty good, and I feel like I'm able to run free for a longer time. Normally when you have been running in 60 or 70 or 80 Ks, your body fell apart. You're running like this, and that is not going to do anything good for your running time.
So that means that actually that the speed is decreasing after 80 Ks.
Yeah.
But on this one, you keep a stable pace all the way through, almost. Relatively stable.
A couple of minutes longer on the second half, but that's okay in 100 Ks.
And you also actually, for the speed, you made a 10K run.
Yeah, and it was a 10K in 4 minutes and 16 seconds, and that's, as far as I'm concerned, the fastest since I got, since we got 2 kids.
Yeah, it's amazing. But I'm super excited to follow you.
Thank you.
And we will continue to follow you and see what the season brings, but you are hopeful.
I am. I think this is a good start on the season, and if I can build on top of that, because I don't have these injuries, I think it'll be a good season.
Cool. But thank you very much for coming.
Thank you, Jonas.
Have a great day.